sitting in front of me, they are just students. I try to expand my own view personally. And you are actually the future of yourself. You are the future of your family. You are the future of organizations. You are the future of the society, of the nation, and actually of the world. The spirit of today's session, so today's effort, is to give you an opportunity or give you exposure at the same time, give you inspiration about the things that you experience. I have heard from many, read also about this, and with the references of a number of researchers, that public speaking is one of the most difficult skills in the world. For people of the world. But I think that this is difficult and most difficult. This is actually easy. Public speaking skill is easy. Difficulties are easy, but only for the greats. Difficulties are easy only for the greats. I want to connect you with a bigger perspective of life. I do not want to limit myself to the perspective of business environment only. Rather, this is a session of interaction, this is a session of public speaking, this is also a session of leadership skill. I want to connect yourself with a bigger perspective of your own originality. If you check yourself that who you are, where you are, you will find that you are the center of the universe. You are the center of the universe. And the Almighty who has created the universe, He has kept you in the center. When He has kept you in the center, what is the purpose of designing this whole universe? If you are in the center of the universe, if you are in the center of the world, what is the most important entity? If you are the most important entity, you are the most responsible entity. If you are most responsible entity, you have got the responsibility of being leader for the whole world. Not the nation only, not the society only, not your organization only, and not your life only. That's why initially I had said, public speaking skill is a very difficult skill, and this is very easy. This is easy because you are by all a leader. You have to be a leader. This is, or this should not be your desire to be a leader. Take my sentence. This should not be your desire to be a leader. This is your responsibility to be a leader. And a leader not only in your performance, in your area of work, but the leader of the whole universe, actually. If you are connecting yourself to your original existence, this is what is the main message that I believe. And in order to connect ourselves to our own originality, we need to become broad-minded also at the same time. Broad-minded in terms of to become able to see ourselves if we are in one position in one organization. I should ask myself, what is my role in that position? I should expand. What is my role in the department? What is my role in the organization? What is my role in the whole industry? What is my role in the society? What is my contribution in modern Indian nation building? And what is my contribution in this world? And where do I stand in this world and in this universe? When you are thinking like this, you would start feeling the original. You are original. Come, go outside the hall, and see the whole universe with your own eyes and feel it personally, feel it first hand that the nature, the components of the nature, they all are made for you. Feel your importance. When you are already more important and you realize your own existence, your own importance. You are a star painting also. Or don't say that you are a star. You are not a star. Painting or thoughts will come in mind. You will get a direction also of life. There are many ways. Which should I choose? There is no confusion at all. There are multiple options of choosing. Which type of life I want to live, or which type of decision I should take, there may be multiple decisions, maybe multiple options, maybe a situation that is compelling you to consider a number of determinations. But they all may be your test. And if you are original, broad-minded, connected to the original existence of your own life, in your organization, your life, your family, society, nation, and the world, and the universe also, there will be no confusion in taking that decision. Actually, I do not want to, and I do not have much of time to expand and extend my speech. I can speak a lot on this also, I think. I will do this. But I want to conclude, taking care of time. I want to conclude with one statement. And I want to, if you permit me, I want to recite one of my poems. And that poem is on clear decision making. And that comes already from connecting yourself with the greater vision. One decision of life, one purpose of life. I have a poem. And that poem is inspired by one story of vision. On his name, there is a mountain. The mountain's name is Raza, that is in Italy. On his situation, I have written a poem. The poem starts, "Live like a legion and die like a legion. Find the one reason to live and die for, and burn your course at the anonymous shore." This is a very concise poem. In future, if I get most of time, I will explain the history of this one.